Dear students, I am Dr. Kumar, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Government Postgraduate College, Shira. The topic of today's lecture is study of mosquito-borne diseases. In that, you need to study chikungunya with respect to control of mosquitoes. So this comes under paper 4, that is Insect Vectors and Diseases, BSc 4th semester, Tumkur University. As all of you know that chikungunya caused by the chikungunya virus, that is chik virus, it is a member of alpha virus genus, that is the genus alpha virus, and belongs to the family Togaviridae. It was first isolated in 1953 in Tanzania and is an RNA virus with a single-stranded genome. Dear students, you need to understand all viruses are having a single-stranded RNA as a genetic material, not the double-stranded DNA. Right? Because it is transmitted by arthropods, namely mosquitoes. It can also be referred to as the family belongs to the arbovirus, or the group of viruses called as arboviruses. They are the arthropod born flies or viruses. This slide shows the chikungunya virus. So this the structure, if you get into the structure, this is very much similar to that of coronavirus, is it not? But only the difference is that the spike proteins or the antigenic determinants which are present on the surface of the virus is quite different. This is what the primary difference between the one virus to the other virus, because the antigenic determinants or the spike proteins which are present on the body surface, they are very peculiar. Okay, they are very particular and they are quite unique, and they are differ in each of the viruses. And chik virus belongs to the family Togaviridae, genus alpha virus, species chikungunya virus. The incubation period of the chikungunya virus ranges from 1 to 12 days and is almost typically 3 to 7 characteristic symptoms includes the sudden onset of high fever, severe joint pain, and rashes also appears on the body. The other symptoms includes headache, fatigueness, digestive system complaints, and conjunctivitis, that is the eye problem. Two stages have been identified as far as the virus is concerned, that is the viral stage and convalescent stage. Viral stage, it is present during the first 5 to 7 days when the virus enters into the body of the host. This is what is called as incubation period, where the virus undergoes some sort of changes or some stages of development that takes place in the body of the host, what is called as incubation period, that is viral stage, followed by the second stage, what is called as convalescent stage, lasting approximately 10 days, during which actually the symptoms develops and also improves, and the virus cannot be detected in the blood. Typically, the disease begins with a sudden high fever that lasts from a few days to a week, and sometimes up to 10 days. The fever is usually above 39 degrees centigrade and sometimes reaching 40 degrees centigrade also, and maybe biphasic, lasting several days. Biphasic means, so belige matte sanje bittu bittu bartakkantadu, breaking and returning. ಅಂದರೆ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಬರೋದು, ಮತ್ತು ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ ಪವರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಮತ್ತೆ ದ ಫೀವರ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಕ್ಕರ್. ಫೀವರ್ ಅಕರ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಆನ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈರಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈರಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಲಡ್ correlate with the intensity of the symptoms in the acute phase. However, the headache, insomnia, and extreme degree of exhaustion remain usually above 5 to 10 days. After about 5 to 10 days, all these symptoms are very much present in the body of the host, where the virus is active in the body. Following the fever, the strong joint pain or the stiffness may also occur. It usually lasts for several months, but sometimes it lasts for years also. The joint pain can occur, resulting in an ear, sometimes immobility. Nadiyodike agavilla anta heltaralla. So athara joint pain varuthe. So joint pain is also occurs in more than one joint. Throughout swelling is uncommon. Swelling irodilla, but the joint pain matra severe joint pain irutte. So all the joints, almost all joints so you can see the severe and acute pain. Typically, the affected joints are located in both arms, arms, legs, and are affected symmetrically. Symmetrically means adu onde kaiyalli varadilla bandre eradu kaiyallu varuthe hage onde kaalalli varadilla eradu kaalige varuthe, right? Like that, symmetrically. Pain most commonly occur in the peripheral joints, such as wrist. Matra wrist enide mungai now bend martivalla alli, ankles kelagade padavanna now move martivalla alli, and the joints of the hands and feet, as well as some of the large joints, typically shoulder joint, elbow joint, knee joint, etc. Pain may also occur in the muscles or the ligaments. Digestive symptoms including abdominal pain, nausea, that is talesuthu varadu, vomiting or diarrhea, loose motion, may also occur. How it is transmitted from one person to one person? Chikungunya is generally transmitted from mosquitoes to humans. During periods of epidemics, humans are the reservoirs of the virus. During epidemic, that means, so when the outbreak occurs, it usually spreading starts, that is the transmission starts from one person to sankramika roga and hentarala epidemic. So humans is the reservoir. Because high amount of virus are present in the blood in the beginning of the infection, and the virus can be spread from one human being to the mosquito and then back to the human beings. During other times, like monkeys, birds, and other vertebrates have served as reservoirs. When the human beings are not involved in the infection, then the other animals like monkeys, birds, and other vertebrates serves as the reservoir. Chikungunya spread through the bites of the mosquito, what is called as Aedes mosquitoes, and the species Aedes aegypti was identified as most common vector. Aedes aegypti is the most common vector which spreads the chikungunya through this, though the virus has recently been associated with many other species, including not only the Aedes mosquitoes, Aedes aegypti, and all, there are several species of the Aedes genus can also be capable, they can also be competent enough to spread the chikungunya and other the disease causing agents. Like for example, Aedes albopictus. Apart from Aedes aegypti, so another species what is called as Aedes albopictus can also able to responsible for the spreading of the chikungunya. The other species potentially able to transmit the chikungunya virus includes Aedes furcifer, Tyleri, and Aedes africanus, and Aedes luteosipalus. These are the different species which are involved in the spreading of the chikungunya. So apart from Aedes aegypti. There are several species belonging to the genus Aedes. Symptoms includes the fever and the joint pain. These typically occur 2 to 12 days after exposure. 2 to 12 days after exposure. The other symptoms may include the headache, muscle pain, joint swelling, and also we can see the appearance of rashes on the body. If you get into the treatment is mainly symptomatic, such as giving painkillers to relieve from the joint pain using non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Drugs are mainly analgesics and antipyretics. That means they are the painkiller drugs. The patient is advised to take fluids very frequently. The use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as naproxen, non-aspirin analgesics such as paracetamol are very useful in order to get rid of this the pain. As far as the prevention is concerned, the most effective means of prevention are the protection against the contact with the disease-causing mosquitoes and controlling mosquito population by limiting their habitat. Mosquito control focuses on eliminating and standing water where mosquito lay eggs and develop as a larva. If elimination of the standing water is not possible, use insecticides and biological control agents can also be added in order to destroy their habitat. Methods of protection against contact with the mosquitoes including the insect repellents with substances such as DEET, that is diethyl toluamide, icaridine, and PMD, that is the drug name by name PMD, that is p-methane-2,8-diol, a substance which is derived from the lemon and eucalyptus tree. Wearing of bite-proof the long sleeves and also trousers offers a protection, and the garments can be treated with pyrethroid chemicals, a class of insecticides that often acts as a repellent, having the repellent property, so that when the mosquitoes comes in contact with the claws which are treated with the pyrethroids, they usually repel due to the effect of pyrethroids. Vaporized pyrethroids can also be used. So these are all very common and they are all available in the market. So there are various mosquito repellent creams are available, can be used to smear to your clothes. When the mosquito comes in contact with the smear, they usually repel. Okay. So vaporized pyrethroids can also act as an insect repellent, as infected mosquitoes often feed and rest inside homes. Homes must be cleaned, hygiene must be maintained at homes. Securing screens and windows and doors will help to keep mosquitoes out of the house. Aedes aegypti and Aedes albopictus are active during the daytime. Mosquito bites for the first week of illness. During the first week of illness, the infection chikungunya virus can be found in the blood. So when doctors advise us for blood test, if you examine the blood under the microscope, you will come across the chikungunya virus. And usually the infected person can be easily diagnosed with a chikungunya virus. Another disease by name, chikungunya encephalitis. Here the term encephalitis meaning is that encephalitis is an inflammation. Inflammation always occurs due to infection. Okay, when the body is infected with the bacteria or virus, usually that is followed, infection is always followed by the inflammation. And after the chikungunya infection, if the inflammation occurs in the body, what is called as chikungunya encephalitis. So, usually if you categorize this as chikungunya encephalitis, it is the inflammation of the brain caused by an infection, that is chikungunya virus or the bacteria, or sometimes it also causes by autoimmune disorder. Autoimmune disorder, it occurs due to some error in the immune system. Chikungunya encephalitis is caused by the virus called chikungunya virus, which is transmitted by mosquito, same thing again. This virus was first discovered in 1952 in Tanzania. Later, it was reported in Africa and Asia. Initially, people infected with the virus only developed illness, which is manifested with a fever, headache, nausea, vomiting, myalgia, rashes appears on the skin, and marked arthralgia, that is the joint pains that would last for 1 to 10 days. Sometimes the people had persistent painful arthralgia causing difficulties to walk when they would eventually walk in a bent fashion. In 2005 to 2006, there was a massive epidemic of chik virus infection, that is what is that occurs in La Reunion Island, and this is La Reunion Island is a famous tourist destination in the Indian Ocean. The outbreak occurs in this island between 2005 and 6. By that time, about a third of the island population, one third of the island population was infected, with more than 200 people developed encephalitis. Excuse me. Chik virus later spread to India, where again many cases of encephalitis were reported, especially among children and elders. During 2015 and 16, the same happened in the northeast regions of Brazil. If you get into the symptoms of chikungunya encephalitis, prior to symptoms of encephalitis, most patients have the illness as described above, that is fever, headache, nausea, myalgia, rashes, and also arthralgia. By a day, 3 to 7 days, some patients develop confusion, behavioral differences, seizure, and lethargy, which are common symptoms for all types of encephalitis. Specific to chikungunya encephalitis is that the patients develop acute renal failure, needing to go on dialysis. So if the internal bleeding can also occur, can be seen here. So because the cerebrospinal fluid damages and the infection occurs in the cerebrospinal fluid, since the infection is followed by the inflammation, naturally sometimes the internal bleeding can also occur, brain hemorrhage can also result. Diagnosis. Firstly, a thorough clinical evaluation of the patient is performed. If encephalitis is presumed, the cause needs to be investigated further. The patient may be asked about the places visited last month. For example, if the patient may be somewhere where the chik virus is circulating, epidemic places. If symptoms and the history of illness point to chik, the laboratory tests that look for the presence of chik virus in the patient's blood and cerebrospinal fluid may also be performed. So far, there is not a specific treatment for chikungunya encephalitis, except for general clinical support and symptomatic treatment for associated symptoms such as the fever, headache and seizures. The prevention, there is not currently a vaccine against chikungunya encephalitis. If you live in or visit an area where the virus circulates, please take effective measures, precautionary measures against mosquito bites. Mosquito control or the prevention of mosquito bites. The most effective way of preventing the virus is to avoid the mosquito reproduction. This is very important. You have to prevent the mosquito reproduction. Mosquito breeding activities must be destroyed. The place in and around you or your residential areas. Avoid keeping items around your houses that store water. That is very important. Mosquito always breeds in the standing water or the stagnant water. Okay, like the drainages which are present in front of your houses, okay, and in kitchen or somewhere in some places of the house where if you have the plant pots, okay, tires, buckets, toys, bowls, bird baths, flower pots, trashes, etc. that contains water, okay, usually you clean those items, remove water from them frequently and clean them. Using N,N-diethylamtolamine, that is DEET, mosquito repellent during the day and at dusk. It is recommended to use concentrations up to 50%. Okay, the higher concentration and the lower the length of protection. Wear long-sleeved clothing which may be treated with mosquito repellent, that is permethrin. Sleep in rooms with air conditioning. Air conditioning is not possible for everybody. If it is so, use air conditioning. And houses with mosquito screens and the windows and also doors. For doors and windows, you should use the screen screens. Check and clean for water holding containers both indoors and outdoors so that the habitat or the breeding activities of the mosquito can be prevented. So this is all about the chikungunya and chikungunya encephalitis. So these are the references and the links. Dear students, this is the time of COVID pandemic. The second wave is operating now. Take the precautionary measures. Okay, don't go outside. Go out only if it is unavoidable and emergency. Okay, wash your hands very frequently. Wear face covering and maintain physical distancing of about 2 meters minimum in the groups. Stay home, stay safe, save lives. Thank you.